championship belongs to the Los Angeles Lakers.
Hello, Lakers Nation. Welcome in. Trevor Lane here for LakersNation.com, your home for everything Lakers. Today, we're talking about some positive comments regarding the purple and gold, some coming from Ice Cube and some coming from LeBron James. Joining me is Ron Gutterman. Ron, how are you doing?
Doing good. Yeah, just almost done with this NBA season. So I guess it's time to start thinking back about that Lakers content.
Yeah, I mean, look, this is when things are going to really start heating up. Once the finals come to an end, everybody's going to shift focus, and we're going to start hearing a lot more about free agency, about the draft, about trades. I think it's going to be the summer of the trade. Things are really going to heat up. And one of the names that's been out there for a bit, I don't think he gets traded this offseason, but it's Damian Lillard. Is it finally time for him to part ways with the Portland Trailblazers? Where Ice Cube put out a little message to Dame just in case he does indeed decide to leave Portland. Here's what Ice Cube told Stephen A. Smith. He said, if you want a championship, you should join the Lakers. If you want to just score a lot of points and be the man, stay in Portland. But come win a championship. You deserve it. He's given a lot to that city, so give some of that love to the L.A. Lakers. I don't think this is going to change Dame Lillard's mind in any way, but I hope that it does. Wouldn't it be great? But, yeah, you know what? Hey, it never hurts to have celebrities vouching for the Lakers.
Yeah, I mean, look, the only hope of Damian Lillard to the Lakers is if he pulls that Anthony Davis, that James Harden type thing and says, I don't want to play anywhere but here, and I'm going to make life very difficult for whoever trades for me. If it's not this team, I guess some celebrity endorsements could push towards that. But yeah, I mean, Damian Lillard's probably staying in Portland just by all things that have been said in the last few weeks.
Yeah, I mean, look, in order for him to get to the Lakers, he would have to go like nuclear, scorched earth here in order for him to find his way to the Lakers. And even then, the Portland Trailblazers could just say no. I mean, look, he has 4 years left under contract. He can't quite control his destination the same way that Anthony Davis could, but he would be a perfect fit with the Lakers if there was some way to make that happen. But at least one of the Lakers stars really wants to stick around. Sounds like he wants to stay for the remainder of his career. LeBron James had some comments about that. Ron, you've got that one.
Yeah, LeBron James on the Smartless podcast hosted by, you know, Jason Bateman, Will Arnett, some other famous movie stars there, said, I truly hope that I can finish my career with the Lakers, however many years that is. If it's 4, 5, 6, whatever, 7, I hope I can continue to play the game. I love being in L.A. My family loves being in L.A.
7 years? He's 36 years old. More years. Is he Tom Brady? What's happening?
Look, 7 is probably a stretch. You know, when LeBron got to Miami, he said they were going to win, you know, not 2, not 3, not 4, not 5. They ended up winning 2. So if we go by that logic, the first number LeBron said was 4, which sounds more reasonable, like an amount of time he could play NBA basketball. So I think, look, if he wants to retire a Laker, give him all the money he wants to do that and every resource he needs to do that.
How many more years do you think he can realistically play? Let's assume that he wants to play as long as he possibly can. What do you think he has left?
I think he can be, I don't know how much longer he has at this level, maybe, you know, 2 years at this level. But if you're talking about how long can he be a positive contributor in the NBA, 4 or 5 years is not out of the realm of possibility here. I mean, look, he's shown just an ability to change his game a way no one else can. He's shown an ability to preserve his body the way no one else can. And if he just avoids freak injuries like Solomon Hill diving at his leg, I think he's got a few, like 4 or 5 years left of pretty good basketball.
Yeah, I agree. I think that as long as we don't keep him, hold him to that standard of you're going to be this dominant force for not forever, right? Then he can continue to play in the NBA. I mean, look at Vince Carter, right? For the last however many years of his career, he was just a role player. And I'm not saying that that's what LeBron's going to be, but I'm saying you just kind of had to accept a little bit of a shift in terms of what he is out there on the floor. And if you're willing to do that, and if you're LeBron James and you just love the game and you want to keep playing, I could see him playing for quite a while. Of course, we're not even fully sure that LeBron James is human at this point. People right now, and it drives me crazy, Ron, people around the NBA, particularly fans of other teams, are looking at LeBron and we're getting that same washed king narrative. It's like we've completely forgotten that he was the MVP this season until Solomon Hill rolled up on his leg. He was the prohibitive favorite to win the MVP, and he was a destroyer of worlds. He was playing at an incredibly high level and was on pace to be the league MVP this season until he got hurt, and it's like we've just totally forgotten that.
Yeah, I mean, look, the first year LeBron was in LA, he got hurt, and everyone said it was over. Proved that wrong, and I imagine he has something up his sleeve this year as well. I don't see LeBron James, you know, falling off at this point just because he's shown so much, and he's shown that unless a freak injury happens, he doesn't really get slowed down, and now he has 4 months to recover. I think it's a scary sight for the league. I really hope they're able to put something around him.
Well, it's recency bias, right? People are thinking, well, we just saw him in the playoffs. He didn't look quite as explosive. That's what a high ankle sprain does. Go look at the NFL. Look at any running back that has suffered a dreaded high ankle sprain. It takes them a while to not just get back on the field, but then when they get back on the field, it takes them a while to get back to where they were, because that's what this injury does to a player. You don't have that same burst. So, of course, LeBron looked a little bit slower coming off of this injury, but people are pointing to that as evidence that he's just done. I can't wait till next season because I think it is going to be a revenge tour for LeBron. Any surprise, though, by him saying that he wants to spend the rest of his career as a Laker?
You know, honestly, when he came to L.A. A few years ago, he signed that four-year contract right off the bat. I thought he made it pretty clear that this is where he wanted to play the rest of his career. To hear him say that is certainly a positive thing. To hear him actually say the words is great. But I think when he signed that first four-year contract, he was saying, look, I'm in this for the long haul. This is where I'm playing the rest of my career.
Yeah, it was a little bit of a surprise when he did that, right? Because for so many years, he had been doing the 1+1 deals in order to maintain that flexibility and maintain that control. He gets to LA and suddenly he's willing to sign a four-year deal. I think it is pretty clear that he likes it here. Obviously, people will point to the movie industry, people will point to the weather and all the other things that aren't Lakers-related stuff, but I think he also likes being a Los Angeles Laker, the history of the franchise, everything that it means to put on that golden armor. I think that's something that matters to him as well, and it is good to hear that he would like to stay and retire as a Los Angeles Laker. We know that is their plan as well, to keep him around for as long as possible. But I think overall, this is good news, and it sounds like LeBron James should be locked and loaded, ready to go for next season. Everybody, give me your thoughts in the comments down below. What do you think about LeBron James retiring as a Los Angeles Laker? And can Ice Cube help in any way to bring Dame time to Los Angeles? Give me your thoughts down below, and don't forget, subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel and ring that notification bell as well. Till next time, stay safe and see you.